So if you actually claim one of these, what are you going to sell? Ooh, we could use. I mean, it doesn't have to work like that. I mean, you could be an assassin for hire or something. That would actually that would suit your skin at least. I might be spectating the I might be spectating the second other ever death games kill. Yeah, I was thinking about it. The thing is, they're really powerful. Try me. Ooh. Over at XP. find out. Affecting to the side of the Dutch. There we go. It would help if I actually had the rockets selected. Ha ha ha. Yes! Yes, I did it! Oh! After so many fucking attempts. You flew right into the water. I'm gonna run out of rockets. Whoa. Where is he? That's six. Why is my head shaking? Hello guys, welcome back to another episode on the CompactCraft server. I'm kind of rushing because my internet has been bad this morning so far, and it's working again, so I really need to get right to it. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be building this dock setup, which is actually a redstone device. Ooh, someone's set up over there. I'm not sure what that is, but okay. I designed this myself last night. There's probably better ways to do it. But I wanted to make it myself and actually manage. The whole idea of this setup is that spawn setups tend to lose boats, and so I wanted the boats to be automatically collected. I wanted them to be collected automatically when they are broken, so you have hoppers under them. And then I also wanted a setup where you could automatically dispense them with a press of a button. And then I had to combine those two things together. Okay, so now let me get the. I'm looking at a picture on my. Well, on the same monitor that I'm using. I don't have a double monitor setup, which would be really nice right now. But. Okay, so. Now what? I know I need 4 hoppers. Not sure which way they should be facing. So one thing I can tell is that, okay, yeah, I figured it out now. Basically, the idea is that the droppers are going under the dispensers, and then the hoppers connect to the droppers. Oop. Yeah. I was thinking about doing this off camera, but I've never done a redstone video on camera before, so I figured, yeah, why not? I don't do that much redstone. I do some, but not a ton of it. There. God, my throat is really. Probably should have grabbed something to drink. That might have been a good idea. Yeah, I think the idea is that this is just extra space for the boats to go. Yeah, I guess I did good. I need to be really careful with how I do the rest of this because I can't have the water get into the system. Okay, so. Which one is this? Is the third one? There we go. Okay. The grass is spreading really quickly. Actually, a pretty big area cleared out here. This is kind of. One part of it requires a decent sized space. I don't think height will be an issue. So I can't dig a block higher than this. In theory, I could just lower it if I really needed to. I don't have a block to, like how Etho uses, or used at least for a time, stone bricks to indicate where redstone is at. I don't have any sort of block like that, so I need to get. I should, anyways, especially since this is a spawn build. There isn't anything good there. This is the little spawn house thing shelter that Dark set up. It's pretty good. An XP set up the roof and that second bit of flooring. Let's see what this shop is all about. You get a lot of XP by disenchanting books. Really? Kilroy's 5 and dime, you pick the price. Gold, diamonds, or emeralds as payment, iron if you must. Books, bows, tools, and armor. Yeah, see, this is what I'm talking about when I say you can customize this. You know. Yeah. Ender pearls. Okay, this is good. I could actually... What's the highest level of Frostwalker? Is it 2 or 3? I don't know. Depster at 3, that's pretty good. Depster at 3. You have a bunch of books. There's a lot of good stuff here. Yes, it's all from fishing. Wait, what? I never saw one. I entered in one. Ooh, Unbreaking 3. That's good. I'm guessing I'm not going to see any mending. Yeah, Unbreaking 3 books are really good. I have, like, enough, though. So I'm set for those for right now. I wouldn't mind Soak Touch for my shovel, but I doubt he's gonna have Soak Touch here because that's too good. I really want to sell something, but I want to sell something that is going to be hard to get. And books are actually good because, well, it's easy to enchant a book and it's easy to fish. There's that random aspect to it, so that's very smart. Yeah. Okay, so I've got my redstone blocks or whatever, not. Okay. Cool. I need to dig down a little bit here. Again, need to be very careful. Looks like it's going to be going down more than it's going up, which is good. Okay. You, then you, then you. I need redstone dust. Comparator. Do I need to put? Who cares? And hoppers. And a block. Yeah, that's a clock. But it's only going to be active very little of the time, so it's not a big deal as far as lag goes. This level, a repeater going into it, and then dig out 6 blocks, yeah, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah, this is how far we need to go out. The reason why is because we're taking advantage of how the length of the comparator when the dropper is full, I think. Yeah. So what we need to do is whenever there's stuff in here, the clock needs to be running to push it up into the dispenser. But when it's full, it needs to be turned off. That's what we're doing here. So it's a sort of, it's a 1-2 punch, so to speak. The clock tells it to go, and then at the end, the clock gets disabled when it's full, essentially. So the last block, yes, the last block is at, so. Goes up one more block. Yeah, so just barely fits below the roads, which is good. This torch doesn't get in the way of that, luckily. And the rest of it goes there, and then the last thing we need is a comparator here. Oh, no. Comparator like that. Redstone. Along the rest of the path. I need to work out how I'm going to actually do a better job at aligning this. Hollowing out, like, an actually, like, not excessive space. I really need iron, so, yeah. Okay, so that's this, that's one of them, which means I'm one third of the way there. I need to put this into test it. Okay, yeah, so it runs a little bit, realizes that that's not necessary, and then turns off, as it should. I wish I had ladders. Let me get some ladders so I can go up and I can go down. Oh,